I'm working on the little hairs of this fractal again. Been around this endless journey many a time, because first I had to kind of sketch the whole thing out in pencil so I know what I'm doing. And so I went over this whole curly Q thing once with pencil. Didn't really do too exact of a job, but just, you know, just enough so I have an idea. Pretty much stayed almost the same. Then I went over it, starting with the light colored outline to define the shape, which is a little bit less rough. And now that I'm doing the dark part on this part going outwards, I'm actually trying to be as exact as possible, and I'll most likely will have to go over it with the white again, and then possibly with the dark again. So it just, you do it back and forth, until everything is just the way you wanted it. But I like the little flaws in this. The white repels some of the paint. And that gives it that interesting effect. Almost like I did a special technique or something. I kind of like it. The painting this has been like a journey into the unknown, because it seems to have a life of its own. Like each little curlicue just tells me how exactly it wants to hold on to that white part. It's like little tiny claws going eek, like grabbing the other color, and I can just sometimes feel it or see it. I want to do a small painting of, say, just a portion of this here painting, and then flip it over on its side and paint that, like with little crevices going down, and like an abyss, with this being the top part of a mountain or something. And yeah, it's gonna be exciting. I like these fractals, they're very meditative, and one painting goes a long ways. Because, you know, like if you went like, but it's sort of the longest path around. Each one has a little hair and another little hair and another little hair and another little hair. And so, you know, if I do a piece like this, this goes around here, it may take an hour or something. Like, it takes a long time. I find it very time consuming, but that's the thing I've decided. The other day I tried to paint with acrylics, and it was so, I used a retarder, and that worked really kind of well. Almost made me feel a couple times like I'm painting with oils, but the next day I had mixed, you know, enough color for pretty much the whole painting. The paint was, even with a retarder, it just sort of dries out, and it rushes, and I'm so used to dawdling, taking my breaks. When somebody comes and interrupts me, I don't have to brush it, you know, wash brushes or anything. I can just leave them there. And, you know, unless it's something that really needs to be blended right away, I can do that later. It's very, it's just, that's the way I paint. I don't, painting is not something you rush. Something you just sort of, it's an art form to paint. I can't imagine to feel rushed while painting. It has a completely different survive about it. Really like to daydream around a painting. Let it sink into my soul. Open up to the thoughts that come up and suit this motion or this design. My eyes are constantly exposed to these patterns of a close-up of a fractal. It can go quite deep, and it's like I'm doing surgery on myself. Like I said before, painting sometimes is like brushing, like an archaeological site. You just brush away at everything until the image that you had already seen is just the way it was in your imagination. And I'm very pleased to say that just it's the ability to transform or translate what's in my head, which isn't always a clear picture, into a visible, clear picture on a canvas is a huge accomplishment for me, because my pictures are in my mind, and so it's like you have to be super clear. But the good part is the creative spirit is, when it's with you, it guides you along. Like this painting is painting itself. I don't have to, you know, I did the rough skeleton, and the coral builds itself onto it, so to speak. Like this fractal just goes and flows by its own self.